strong game. Now the last two plays, they've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Go to 50. Hey, you block over here. Hey, 88, 88, 88. Back north.
And again, it's Rodgers. Flushed out right. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal.
Yeah, this, 26. Inside. Number 50.
Rodgers now to throw. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Two touchdown passes now here in this first quarter for Aaron Rodgers. And the Falcons have moved out in front. Extra point up and good by Folk. And that makes the score 14-7. Folk now set to boot it after his guys put six on the board. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And he'll get to the 30-yard line before going out of bounds. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left.
I don't care who you put on him. He's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man. Maybe needs some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
On second and inches, Rodgers on target over the middle of the hill. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Through one corner, 14-7, our score. 14, Texans 7. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
88, 88, 88. Cali, don't let Cali.
Now Rodgers. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
He already came through for them on this drive. No surprise that they were hoping he could do it again.
Back north. Hey, flex, flex.
Rodgers again now. He finds his man complete. It's Gonzalez. A good chance this is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three.
26. Inside.
Throwing is Rodgers. His pass out wide to Hall. And it was the stiff arm there that freed him enough to get the first before he's tackled. So first and 10 now from the 30.
Hey, Mike.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try to get two more stops and escape this drive.
Jump out!
Again, they'll throw with Rodgers.
He dumps this one off here to Hall.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
26.
Into the red zone. It's Rodgers. He finds his man complete. It's Gonzalez. To throw again on second down. Rodgers.
Texans are an extra point away from evening this one up. Extra point by Butkus on target, and we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And a short kick taken at about the 16.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. A lot of time for this unit to game plan on the sideline after that drive that they watched the other side just score. But remember, last time they were out, they scored as well. We'll see if they can seize that momentum right back.
And they haven't had a lot of time to cool off from reaching the end zone the last time. So have they been able to keep themselves mentally sharp and into this game, even though they haven't been on the field? And you and I both know, one big play, though, gets them right back up to that level.
Easy. Come on. Yeah, live. Where y'all going?
Now Rodgers. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. Chris Jones coming right up the gut. Gets in there for a loss of 9. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Inside. Number 50. Wide left.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. And it's a fumble. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. A disappointing end of the sequence there. He was starting to turn nothing into something, and then he lost the football.
And sometimes things get lost in the transition. And what I mean by that is you go from being a passer to a runner. And at a certain point, once you cross the line of scrimmage, you're strictly a runner now. There's no more downfield threat. Make sure you take care of the football while you're traversing downfield.
Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. And he'll be brought down at the 27.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does. And the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Jeff! Hey, 88! Box it! Good. Back north. Plant. Yeah, this. 26. Zoom. Inside. 150.
Here's Rodgers to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it. And the Falcons are going to get the football here at their own 23.
Dennis! Back north. Stay right. 10:30. Jeff! Get 300. Right.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well. And every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
Don't go over here.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. Yards to pick up the first. He finds his man complete. It's Gonzalez. Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts as the clock has stopped with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Jake Bailey on now to punt here on fourth down. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. Six yards on the boot. The coverage holds him to just 3 on the return. And controlling the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
88.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. They'll wind up losing three there on the sack. Good pressure, and it's second down. So we've hit halftime all even at 14 apiece. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. To get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And he is out of bounds as they'll start up past the 30. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half, because we've seen both sides score almost a goal here in the first half. And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
Hey, take 20, go to 50. Back north. Zoom, zoom. Flip again.
Rodgers now on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Gonzalez. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds.
Hey, Mike.
Throwing again on second down. Rodgers toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
50. Hey, Mike. Take 30. Get 300. Get 300. Box it, box it, box it, box it.
Rodgers to throw once more. He finds his man complete. It's Gonzalez. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line.
Hey, take 26.
To throw, it's Rodgers. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an outboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Go to 50. Hey, you find out. You got 58.
To throw is Rodgers. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Tyreek Hill. His second touchdown of the night. And the Texans have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead is now 21-14. And a short kick taking it about the 16. Oh, and miscommunication on the lateral. The ball's out. And the Texans scoop it. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
As that ball got away from him, and he saw the opposing team recover it.
You felt his pain?
Oh, I felt his pain, and he knew what was going through his head. Tuck it away. Mm. Take care of the ball. All the things he hears all week in practice, he didn't carry it over into the game.
Hey, 88! Lance, back north. Yeah, this.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Now it's Rodgers. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Well, they approached this drive with a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he was fortunate on that one. Not down for another turnover on his ledger.
So the big return had him fired up, but in the end, the offense stalls out. They only muster three.
Yeah, the excitement was there after the return, but they didn't move the ball at all after that. They didn't even get a first down.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. Fields it right around the goal line. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're down now 24-14. What to do as they come up on a first and 10. Rodgers gonna throw. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's gonna be able to pick up decent yardage.
Jumbo!
Looking to throw again on second down. Rodgers, he finds his man, complete. It's Gonzalez. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Get 300.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Inside.
Here's Rodgers. And he's going to go down. The Texans come at him. It was Melvin Ingram that time who shot in to bring him down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Let's see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down.
Jumbo! Hey, take 26!
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. He's got a man complete. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
Well, partner, that's how you make a long drive suddenly not so long anymore.
One big play
in the opening field goal range with designs on getting more than that.
And he's got his man in stride complete. And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Being chased out left. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it, incomplete.
Nice job escaping the pocket. And boy, he took the shot downfield towards the end zone, didn't he? Trying to go for six. It just wasn't there against that coverage. They were ready to prevent the big play.
They'll run with a longtime Buccaneer. It's Mike Alstott. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. A lot of tired bodies on that field. But this is a big play, third and goal. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. This defense bending but not breaking. It's a gain of 3. It's now fourth and goal.
I know this is your spot, partner, so forgive me for jumping in. But there's no decision right here. They have to go for it in this situation. They're down on the scoreboard. How many other opportunities are you going to get?
Yeah, I'm with few fourth quarter, like you said, down on the scoreboard. And remember here, a field goal virtually does them no good.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Tony Gonzalez there to make the grab. And the Falcons have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Fulk connects on the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Fulk now set to boot it after his guys put six on the board. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they're going to have good starting field position. He's out of bounds, but not before he's across the 35. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game here in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all three timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as early as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the two-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
Hey, 88!
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down.
Flex!
Throwing now is Rodgers. He finds his man complete. That's Gonzalez. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. If you're the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
Over. Yeah, this.
Throw left side, taken in by Hill. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. To throw is Rodgers. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And he'll get this back across the midfield, striping down to the 47-yard line.
Oh, my, how the tables have turned now. They were trying to salt this one away, but that interception, potentially a game-changer.
And I just got to think to myself, at this point of the game, I know you've been aggressive. I know that's your M.O., and that's fine. And all those teams that talk about all gas, no brakes, you better have an emergency lever to pull occasionally. They could have used it right there. They put themselves in a tough spot with that interception.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
88, 88, 30.
Now Rodgers. Flush to his right.
And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. As the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth.
Jumbo!
Back to throw, Rodgers. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
Boom, boom. Hey, take 26. Go to 50. Hey, you block over here.
Rodgers to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath. And let's us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple guys in the huddle. So they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Hey, 88, That's it. Box it, box it, box it, box it. Inside.
They'll look to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
What an outstanding drive right there to take the lead. And also, Charles, didn't leave their opposition with a whole lot of time on the clock.
Yeah, I like the way that you're viewing this because they did a tremendous job to put themselves in a position to win. But they can't celebrate just yet. They've got to clamp down on any big plays and force them to use up those timeouts without making any headway.
Very short kick taken right at the 20. And he is out of bounds as they'll start up past the 30. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
We'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in this second half.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. I see you nodding your head up and down. It's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
It's a smart play because you're not about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away, live to fight another down.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third.
It's fourth down. Get 300. Get 300. Zoom, zoom. Jumbo!
Now Rodgers gotta have this one. And it's incomplete. They turn it over. So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. Doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened, they got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons. And it took a big fourth quarter to do it, but they were able to get the job done, and that's the bottom line.
No doubt about it. And let's face it, they had to be more than nervous in the fourth quarter. But a lot of that was their own doing. I think you observed during the game, their energy level just didn't seem to be there. But in the fourth quarter, somehow they dug deep and found that extra bit, right, that reserve tank. They hauled it out. Offense scored some points. Defense held them. And lo and behold, they walk away with a win. Maybe expend a little more energy than they expected to, but they'll take it.